It will be the third time in just 7 years Slovenians head to the polls. There are new faces, but it's the front runner, Janez Janša, who leads the Slovenian Democratic Party, who's the familiar one here. A former prime minister who had to resign over a corruption scandal 5 years ago. It's not his past people are focusing on, though, but his hardline rhetoric on immigration and his ties to Hungary's nationalist leader, Viktor Orban. 500,000 people fleeing war and poverty passed through Slovenia in 2015 on their way to Western Europe. Since then, migration has been pushed up the electoral agenda. Janša told a rally last week Slovenia is defending the Schengen border of Europe.
It's an easy stance to take if you say to the people, immigration is the main issue, and that's why your country isn't prospering. And if you vote for me, I can help fix that. That's something that anyone can say. And it's worked to an extent within the US. It's worked as a startup movement in France with Marie Le Pen. And it's taken popular rise in other EU countries.
Other party leaders have warned they won't work with Janša if, as expected, there's no outright winner. The election was called after the resignation of Miro Cerar over the failure to deliver a railway project. He wants his job back. Others are trying to gain more centre-ground voters to attract both the left and the right. The economy too and how to improve it will play a big part in how people vote. In Slovenia, the average monthly salary still falls short of the average elsewhere in the Eurozone, with the impact of a double-dip recession still being felt.
People with well-paid jobs are leaving the country, while those who come take less-paying jobs. Looking from a fiscal perspective, that is a disaster.
Slovenia's economy is growing. A new leader will want to keep it moving in the right direction. No one party is expected to get enough votes to win outright. So all eyes in the days after the election will be on who will join forces to create Slovenia's next government. Emma Hayward, Al Jazeera.